got to say, say, man. Yeah. Walking down Milky Lane, not long ago. Or maybe we should talk like this when you're in your devotion at night and you're talking from New Beginnings or Tabernacle, or you're talking from Haynes or wherever it may be this morning. You find out that you begin to speak things and all of a sudden you say, well, I want to make a stand, guys. I don't think we need to say those jokes no more. I don't think we need to do those things no more. I don't think we ought to listen to that stuff no more. I don't think we ought to talk about that girl no more. Everybody understand me? Say amen. It's in a place right there where Jeremiah is stepping up. He's actually doing what God is telling him to do. But here's the problem. Though he stands up and he begins to talk about what God had actually told him to do, the problem was is everybody hated him. I'm going to tell you this tonight, or this morning, you actually know this, that anytime you try to stand up, you talk about what God's telling you to do, or what thus saith the Lord, you ain't always going to have a bunch of friends. Can I get an amen? Sometimes it is very difficult. Sometimes it's very hard. Let me tell you what I preach on this morning so you understand. It's about having a group of people that we got and the friends that we have, but for you to understand that there are the right friends and there are the wrong friends. The Bible says here in this text that they begin to do this. They pressed against him. And the Bible says that whenever they had drunk him down in there, that he came to this place in verse number 7. The Bible says there was a man by Ebed-Melech. The Bible says that when he came,